everyone, welcome to my channel, 10 Ways to Wear It. I'm Alicia, and on this channel, I take one fashion item or one fashion trend and show you guys 10 different ways to wear it. Now, I have a super exciting video planned for you guys today. I'm gonna be showing you guys how to mix prints, and I cannot tell you the timing of this video is so perfect because I mix prints the most during the fall. And I gotta tell you guys, so much of my frustration when like getting dressed and trying to figure out what to wear to different events and things like that has been trying to figure out if things go together, like two pieces of pants and a pair of pants and a shirt, and I'm like, does this go together? Does this fit? These days I'm like, what the hell does that even mean? Like, things don't go together. People do. Like, me and him go together. Like, a shirt and a pair of pants don't need to go together. And I really had to let that go because I would feel so frustrated trying to figure out what items to put together, only to get dressed and feel bored with my outfit, feel like I look like I tried too hard because everything's so damn matchy, or just feel like I'm outdated, like I'm just out of style because I took items that I felt went together more than items that I really, really loved and that complemented each other. And so in today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys how you can mix prints and wear them with confidence, how you can take really, really bold prints and clash them together and just have so much fun with your wardrobe. I'm gonna be sharing with you guys my three principles that I use for mixing prints, and I'm gonna be doing that with 10 different outfits, you guys. So you know I always gotta come through with that 10 for y'all, okay? Cause she's a 10. That's bullshit. I mean, anyways, I am, you guys. Come on, give me that 10, come on. Give me that dime. Anyway, I'm gonna be showing you guys 10 different outfits, and I'm gonna talk you guys through them on why I mixed them together, why I think it's okay to pair those patterns or those designs or those textures together, and I'm super excited to do that for you guys today. Please stay tuned for this awesome video on mixing prints. Hey, let's mix it up on these bitches. I taste just like candy. All right, guys, I got my clothing rack here full of my 10 outfits, and I am ready to play in some clothes. First, let's get into this first outfit. It's gonna be this really, really cute shift dress, and it's sort of like a taupe colored or plaid colored dress. It has like just a really plain kind of pattern on it, but I absolutely love the color and the shape of this dress. I recently picked this up from Boohoo. I'll have all these items linked below, you guys. But how I would contrast this little dress is to wear it with these knit tights. Now, these tights have like sort of a paisley print on there. I hope you guys can see that. It has like a paisley print on it, sort of like a floral print, but it really creates a nice contrast for this dress. You'll see in the try on how cute this looks together. This is definitely something that I would wear to like a church event or even a business meeting, or if I had like a staff meeting at work where I can not have to wear my uniform, I definitely would wear this outfit. I think it's really, really cute, and just paired with some simple little boots, it looks adorable, you guys, and it really gives me that play with my clothing, that contrast with the plaid dress, and then those stockings just bringing in that kind of fun paisley print. I absolutely love the contrast of this outfit, and I love that it has the common element. The common element in this outfit is the color. Even though these two things are on different ends of the spectrum, you got a paisley print and a plaid, the color kind of ties it all together. So that's one of my principles, using a common element to tie items together. Now I'm gonna go into my next outfit, and it's gonna be three pieces. It's this striped cardigan here that I picked up from Forever 21. Also, this striped shirt that I recently picked up, you guys saw this in my fall haul from H&M, and these pants. These are from Target. These are from Target's Wild Fable line that they have out now. But you'll see how cute these three items look together. And look at how different they are when I just hold them up. You know, the stripes on this shirt is so bold. You know, the cardigan is kind of more muted. And then you have the bold stripes on the side of these joggers with that tweed in there. But together, these three items look awesome. You'll see in the try on, it just makes a really, really cool laid back outfit. I absolutely love it. I think it definitely can be worn with boots. It can be worn with, you know, the old school Vans, the black and white Vans. It can be worn with a lot of different shoes. I absolutely love it. This is definitely a good back to school outfit, or if you're a college student, something that you can definitely throw on when it gets a little cooler out. I absolutely love it. I love the yellow. I love the boldness. I love the black and white. Really awesome little outfit. The next outfit is gonna be this one. Now look at how bold this is, you guys. This is so daring. This shirt is from Forever 21. It's kind of like a geometric print on there. This is sort of like a rust color in there, and then the shirt overall is teal with a little bit of white lining in there. And these are yellow plaid pants from Pretty Little Thing. I recently picked these up. Everything in this video will be linked below, you guys, so I know you're gonna fall in love with some of this stuff. But look at the, if you look closely, you can see, and I hope my lights aren't washing everything out, but the pants have a teal in there. They have burgundy and they have teal in there, along with the yellow and some black. So to tie it in, that teal kind of reaches for the shirt. It almost like it just says, look, we go together, you know? So again, that even though these are on opposite ends of the spectrum, they kind of have a common element in the colors. You know, this rust can really complement this yellow, and then you have that little bit of teal in the pants that kind of complements the shirt. So it really ties the outfit together, and I really, really love this outfit. You'll see in the try-on how cute it looked together, you guys. Again, reaching for opposite ends of the spectrum is another great principle that I use when mixing prints. It's like you gotta just say F it and put the shit together. And usually it comes out really, really cute. And I think that's what a lot of models and fashion people do. I think they just take two opposite things, clash them together. You see that a lot on like Fashion Week, you know, the street styles that you'll see and the runway styles, where they just kind of took two things and put them together and it's just like, hey, here it is. But the things are so nice and so awesome that they work. So moving on to the next outfit, you guys. It's gonna be another three-piecer. It's gonna be this bold plaid yellow shirt. I think you guys recently saw this in one of my videos, my transition video. This is like a Pendleton shirt. It's really thick wool shirt. And then I have these camo pants, you guys. Look at how nice this already looks together. I mean, just the yellow, the boldness of this buffalo print shirt and that camo. Like, that is so badass, right? And then I'm gonna use this black sweater to tie it all together. So this takes me to my next principle, and that's the tie-in element, like using something to tie everything together. This sweater is gonna be touching both pieces. It's gonna be touching the pants, it's gonna be touching the shirt. So it kinda like brings it together. And you can do that with a belt, it can be done with a blazer, a jacket, a shirt, anything like that. So look at this outfit and check out how it comes together, you guys. You saw in the try-on how cute it looks. Oh my god, I absolutely love it. If you really are having like a bold day, let's say you're going to like a really cool concert or something like that, going to hear some bomb ass music, that is a really great outfit to rock. And you can wear this with a lot of different shoes. You can dress it up with some gladiator heel sandals, some open toe boots, stiletto boots, closed toe booties, like stiletto booties. Or you can dress it down with like some old school Vans or some other type of sneakers. You guys, come on now. Mix those prints. Let's do this. Moving on to the next outfit, it's gonna be this one. This goes back to that common element principle I was talking about. You got this striped navy and white shirt, which has like a really, really small fine stripe on it. And then you have these green palazzo pants that has like a really big bold stripe on them. But the common element is that they're both stripes. They're kind of different textures. The shirt is a little softer than the pants, but they're still kind of flowy. But when you put them together, that common element that they have really ties them together. And you'll see in the cutout how cute this looks together, you guys. This really, really nice structured shirt with these flowy pants makes such a great combination. And a lot of times people wouldn't even think to put something like this together, but imagine wearing something like this to work if you work in an office environment. Honey, you go in and people are gonna be like, wow, you look so cute. Like, I love how you put things together. And I get those kind of compliments a lot, you know, because lately I've just stepped out of that box of feeling like things need to match together. So this is a really great combination. You can wear this with white sneakers. You can wear this with a different color shoes altogether, some red loafers, anything like that to just really be bold with it. I like to button the shirt up all the way to the top like you saw in the insert, but I absolutely love how this little outfit comes together, and definitely something I would wear to a business meeting, to a staff meeting at work, anything like that. The next outfit is gonna be this one here. Now, I did something similar to this in one of my summer lookbooks, part three. I had a striped pair of pants that was actually a different pair of pants. I love me some striped pants, so I have a couple of pairs. That was actually this pair. But this pair is a little bit longer, a little bit more flowier. But I paired it with this red kimono. And the two of these couldn't be further opposites, you guys. You got this modern stripe. The pants even have a contrasting stripe on the side here. You see that? And then you have this really, really bold floral print and in the color red on this kimono. But together, these two items look great together. And you'll see in the insert, I just tied them together with a black bodysuit. And you see how that bodysuit just kind of connects the two things and makes them look seamless? I absolutely love that. And I think this is so cute, so bold, definitely a great outfit to walk down the street on during fashion week or something like that. And it's just like, wow, look at her. Like, this is something you have to wear with confidence, you guys. But I absolutely love this combination. I think it looks so great together, and looking forward to wearing this outfit. Actually, I wore a similar outfit to this in my summer lookbook, but it was actually this outfit here. So that one's going to be very similar to this. I think you guys saw this. I kind of paired it down with a pair of sneakers, but I'll probably dress this one up a little bit more when I do wear it out. So the next outfit that I have is one that I really, really love for like a casual date night or just like a chill weekend outfit. And it's going to be this floral print skirt and this striped t-shirt. This skirt is from TJ Maxx. I picked this up on tjmaxx.com. If it's still available, I'll have it linked below. And this shirt is from Old Navy. I absolutely love this little combination. Again, this is an element, this is, features the element of commonality as well as reaching on the opposite ends of the spectrum, because you have this striped shirt, really, really simple t-shirt, and you have this really flowy, fluttery floral print skirt. Both of these items are blue, which kind of have that common element I was telling you guys about. They're both navy blue, but also they're on opposite ends of the spectrum, and I just clashed them together and said, F it, you know? But it came out looking really, really cute, you guys. I absolutely love it. You'll see in the insert how cute this looks. And this is an outfit that looks great with some sneakers, or if you have some shoes that are one of these colors in there, the navy blue, white, orange, whatever, yellow, it would look really, really cute with this as well. Some cute little flats. But I absolutely love this combination. I think it brings in that element of being casual, but also being feminine and frilly and girly. So I really, really love that. You have a couple more tie-in elements, the orange in the t-shirt, as well as the little kind of orange in the skirt. You have the yellow in the skirt. So those bright colors also kind of pop out and kind of grab each other and make these two items look really great together. So I love this little outfit. Definitely cute for a movie night with me and my boo. And I definitely plan on rocking that. The next outfit I have is going to be another three-piecer. Really, really bold pieces. It's going to be this leopard print off-the-shoulder bodysuit paired with these destroyed jeans with these tartan leggings underneath. Now, this is a really, really awesome fall outfit, you guys. I absolutely love the contrast of this really, really bold leopard print with the tartan. And the tartan, it just kind of pops through the jeans. So it's not too much. They're not right up on each other. They're not right next to each other. But you can definitely see the contrast of these two items in this outfit. And the tie-in element was the black belt that I had on. That black belt just kind of brought everything together and really made the outfit look seamless and look really, really cute. And that's where you get that tie-in element. That one thing that kind of brings the pieces together and makes the outfit look seamless, really, really chic and really, really effortless. So I love incorporating a tie-in element if things are just really on the opposite ends of the spectrum, and it really just brings the outfit together. So I love this outfit. Definitely a cute like girls night out outfit or date night outfit if you want to look sexy. I love it. Looks cute with open toe heels, like sandal heels. Looks great with open toe booties. I definitely plan to like dress it up more than down, but love that outfit. The next one I have is another really, really cute and quirky little combination, and it's on opposite ends of the spectrum, my favorite, you guys. That contrast just really gets me. I love this polka dot shirt that I picked up recently from ASOS. You guys probably saw this in my recent haul, and these houndstooth pants from Old Navy. I love these cigarette style pants that Old Navy has. They're really, really chic and just clean. The lines on them are super, super clean. And I love these pants. I'll have them linked below, you guys. If you haven't checked out Old Navy's like corporate wear, please do. They have some really great corporate wear. But I love these pants with this top because, again, you have the common element. They're both black and white. That's the common thing between them. And then you can throw on a tie-in element to bring them together. A belt, a blazer, which I use the blazer to kind of pull it together. But I really, really love this outfit. You'll see in the insert how cute it looked together. This would be great for a meeting, a business meeting, or just anything where you want to kind of look smart and you know, classic, but also look really, really chic and cool. So I really love this outfit. Another thing you can do to add another just a little zip to this outfit is to add a belt that is a pop of color. So a bright pink belt, a red belt, a yellow belt would look really, really cute to tie this outfit together. And I absolutely love it together. It's so cute. Definitely has that kind of secretary vibe, but definitely the like modern chic secretary vibe to it. So I love that combination. The next outfit I have is definitely going to be more of a laid back, chill kind of outfit. It has the common element. It's this plaid shirt and these mixed print plaid pants. Now this kind of brings in three plaids because these pants have two patterns on them. They have a red plaid and a green plaid. And then you have this white large check print shirt. So really, really love this combination. The combination together definitely create like a more laid back school, like if you're on college campus and you just want to look chill kind of look. But I love it together with some sneakers. This outfit looks really, really cute. It kind of has a quirky vibe to it, but definitely something I would walk around if I was still a student, walk around on campus on, or just something to throw on and go out to the grocery store or go shopping if you're just gonna be out really quick. I absolutely love this. And honestly, if you're going out, like going out, this is a really cute outfit to wear because it just kind of has that cool Harajuku girl kind of vibe to it. Like this is something that I could definitely see some of the Asian girls here in California wearing. They dress so, so cool. Like definitely Asian girls will show you how to mix some prints because they do it so effortlessly and so cool. I really, really love the way some of the girls dress out here, and I really get some tips from a lot of Asians. I went to UCLA for a little bit, and the Asian girls on campus always dress so cute. I just used to be like, wow, the way they put things together, really, really bold. And I think you see a lot of that also in Asian countries like China and Japan, the more like modern chic areas of those countries. You'll see some really, really cool fashion. So I like this, and it kind of reminds me of them. So the last outfit that I have for you guys is one that I think is really, really cool. It kind of takes two elements that aren't really close to each other and really clashes them. And it's going to be this African print dress. This is a tie waist shirt dress that I absolutely love. It's from a website called Dianu, and it is absolutely gorgeous. I'm going to bring it up close so you guys can see. Look at the patterns on this dress. Oh my goodness. I mean, it's so many colors in here. Pinks, reds, greens, yellow, blue, green, all that. Like, I just love it. The purple, absolutely gorgeous dress, and it really gives you such a nice silhouette. You guys, I will have this link below. But I paired this dress with these spotted booties, and I love the combination, you guys. I mean, talk about a clash. Look at that. Look at how this clashes. But you see in the insert how cool it looks together, you guys. I absolutely love this combination, and this is another way that you can mix prints and really, really be bold with it, using pattern shoes, pattern boots, and just another pattern item, pattern pants, pattern shirt that are a different pattern, and just putting them together. It looks so cool, you guys. I really, really love to do that with other things like scarves, turbans on my head, anything that has a pattern on it that's not a actual clothing piece. You can clash it with a clothing piece, like, so you can have on something really, really modern and sleek on and have on like an African print head wrap, and the shit looks so awesome, you guys. I've done it, and I get so many compliments just putting stuff like that together. So I absolutely love this. Like, imagine you can totally just wear this with some black boots or some black shoes or whatever, but when you put it together like this, look at how cool that is. Look at how confident that is, you guys. So that's what I'm saying. Like, just going those opposite ends of the spectrum really, really can make you look cool, make you look chic, make you look current, and just make you look really, really confident, you know? So that's outfit. I got a few more things I want to talk to you guys about. So now that we've made it through our 10 outfits, you guys, I want to make a couple of other points that you can do. If you're not quite ready to pair items together, there's a lot of options out there that already do that for you. So I want to show you guys a few options besides the top that I'm wearing. This is definitely a mixed pattern top. And again, this features that kind of tie-in element. Both are paisley prints, but they're just two different colors. But I want to show you a few more items. The first being this dress. You guys saw this dress in my recent fall haul. I picked this dress up from Asos. I think it was on sale for like $22 or $21. But I really love this. This is another really cool contrast that you can buy right off the rack. It has polka dots and this like paisley print floral pattern in there. Really, really cute. But again, this is something that kind of reaches somewhat on the opposites because you have these big dots on there and then you have the paisley print on there. So really, really cute dress if you're not ready to mix your own patterns. Another option that you guys saw in one of my recent videos, my ugly sneakers video, was this dress. This is a great dress that contrasts two really bold patterns. It has the cheetah print on here, and then it has this nice big blue print on here. And then the cheetah print and the other print completely clash as far as the colors. So really, really bold way to put two prints together, you guys. And you can buy this right off the rack. This dress comes in regular and plus sizes. I'll have it linked below. Hopefully it's still available in all sizes. But another way that you can mix prints without having to think about it or do it yourself. Another thing I featured in a recent video of mine was this outfit here. You might have saw in my summer lookbook, part three of my summer lookbook. I kind of put this together as more of a casual outfit because I wore it with some black sneakers. But this is something also that can be dressed up. You can wear some nicer sandals with it. You can wear boots with it. But these wide leg striped pants and this red floral print shirt. You saw this in my summer lookbook. Really, really cute outfit, but look how opposite these two pieces are. I mean, really, they couldn't be further from each other, right? You have the really, really modern stripes, and then you have this bright red, almost orange floral pattern. And putting them together looks awesome, you know? It really has that contrast, but it really comes together. And I didn't use any tie-in elements for this. I just tied the shirt, and it looks really, really cute together, you guys. So those are some other options for you that I just wanted to share before I go to my outro. Thank you guys so much for watching my video on mixing prints. I really, really hope you enjoyed it. I had so much fun making this video because I gotta tell you, mixing prints, contrasting patterns and things like that really fits my personality. So I have really learned to get comfortable with doing it and to really show my personality in my clothing. So I wanna go over my three principles again on mixing prints. Basically, you can pretty much put any type of prints together as long as you have these three elements. The first is have a common element between the two items, meaning have two types of plaids, or if you're gonna have two different types of plaids, have them be the same color or the same texture. That's a common element. If you have like a red plaid tartan and like a large buffalo tartan, put those together. Like, that's the common element. They're both plaid. Whether they're different colors, whether they're different textures, it doesn't matter. Or you want to have a tie-in element. The tie-in element could be any item that touches both items. So a belt, a blazer, a coat, anything like that, a jean jacket that kind of pulls those items together and really makes it look seamless and like they make a good match. So it can be a belt. Sometimes you'll have on two completely contrasting patterns. You put on a large belt in between it and it's like, wow, it almost looks like a dress or something, you know? So you can definitely tie any item together with a common element or with a tie-in element. The last thing is, don't be afraid to reach on opposite ends of the spectrum. Do not be afraid to mix a paisley print with a modern stripe. Don't be afraid to mix polka dots with plaids, things like that. When you do something like that, it really shows a boldness and a confidence in your clothing. Do not be afraid. So that's another thing you can do. The third element, go to opposite ends of the spectrum and just put them together. Make sure it's two things that you really, really love, whether it's a skirt, a pair of pants, a pair of culottes, and a really nice top, blouse, shirt, t-shirt, whatever it is. Take those two things, put them together, and wear them with confidence. I think when people reach on different opposite ends of the spectrum, sometimes it really comes together in like this seamless, effortless outfit. I see a lot of models, a lot of fashion people doing things like that. And you look at their outfits and it just looks like, wow, like how did she come up with that? But a lot of times it's just because they put on things that they really, really love. They didn't care that they were complete opposites, a polka dot, a stripe. They just put it together and said, this looks adorable together. And that's that's usually how we see it. But when it comes to ourselves, we're hesitant to do it. So be bold with your fashion, show your personality, mix those prints, wear those things you love, you guys. Thank you so much for sitting through another video. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do. I have so many awesome videos coming up for you guys. You guys, I'm really, really working hard to get my channel to the level that I know that it can be. I have people helping me with that. I have friends, I have family, I have an awesome, awesome wizard, my videographer and editor. So I'm really working hard for you guys, and I am gonna get this channel to an optimal level. It's gonna stand out. You guys, don't miss out on the journey. Don't miss out on these awesome videos and my awesome lookbooks. Thank you again for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Me and my puffs. Mix it up on those bitches out there, y'all. Come on now. It's fall.